On this channel, I tend to make a lot of videos about movies and video games that I enjoy. However, recently it's occurred to me that I've never talked about these shows that I like. A few weeks back, I watched the South Korean action thriller series, My Name, for the first time, and I haven't been able to stop thinking about it since. So I figured that this might be a great opportunity to finally start talking about shows on this channel. If, like me, you enjoyed movies such as John Wick, The Raid, The Villainous, or just in general really enjoy crime thrillers, revenge thrillers, or films with expertly choreographed action, then My Name is definitely up your alley. So stick around and let's discuss. Before we continue with the video, I'd just like to say that my debut science fiction novel is out now. Link in the description below. Now, on with the rest of the video. My Name is a crime drama Netflix limited series, which premiered October 2021, directed by Kim Jin-min and written by Kim Bada. I apologize if I butchered the pronunciation of either of those names, and I also apologize in advance for any other Korean names I'm probably about to butcher. The series stars Han So-hee as protagonist Yoon Ji-woo, aka Oh Hye-jin. Ji-woo is a woman whose father, Don-hoon, is a wanted gangster on the run. One fateful night, she witnesses his death at the hands of a masked assailant. Scarred and grief-stricken after this event, Ji-woo dedicates her life to finding her father's killer and getting revenge at all costs, joining the organized crime ring that her dad worked for in order to learn the skills she needs to learn in order to kill the man responsible. Eventually, Choi Moo-jin, leader of the criminal organization and also Don-hoon's closest friend, tells Ji-woo that they found the weapon used to murder her father, a revolver used by the police force, making it evident that the murderer was a cop. So with that, Ji-woo infiltrates the police force, going undercover throughout the course of the next 5 years in order to try and find the cop who killed her dad and take her revenge. That's the overall premise of the series, but I won't be going into spoilers, nor will I explore the story in depth until much later on in this video. So for now, let's start off with my spoiler-free thoughts on this series. First of all, I really enjoyed the writing in this series. The story of My Name is one that is dense with ethical and moral ambiguity, set in a grounded and gritty world of violence and crime. The show's revenge narrative focuses a lot on the repercussions, consequences, and emotional cost of vengeance. Ji-woo is a very sympathetic and likable character who we are endeared to as a result of her trauma, following her story from adolescence all the way through to adulthood, watching this troubled young girl eventually evolve into an extremely capable, hardened, and badass fighter. Her story is one of grief and betrayal, and the longer the series goes on, the more you want to see her find peace, especially because she lives a life where there is no joy or levity. Her entire purpose in the world revolves around avenging her father. The trauma of not only losing him, but also witnessing his death has left lasting scars on her that have refused to heal and make it very difficult for her to open up to or trust those around her, even her partner in the police force. The action is also a very strong highlight in this series. I was actually very pleasantly surprised by just how good the fight scenes were in this show, and I highly recommend checking the series out just for them. The action is fast-paced, brutal, and by the time we reach the end of the series, it gets very bloody and very intense. My favorite action sequence in the entire series is the very last one during the final episode. This was very memorable to me because at this point of the story, the show stops holding back. Not only is it the most unhinged out of all the fight scenes, but it's also the most powerful and emotionally driven. Ji-woo is at her most dangerous and badass at that point in the story. It's awesome. The action in My Name is further enhanced by the show's cinematography and soundtrack. It has a superb cinematic production value, feeling less like a Netflix show and more like an 8-hour movie. As for the soundtrack, I think the highlight for me personally is the show's main theme by Hwan Sang-joon, featuring Swervy and Jimin. This song has been stuck in my head for days, and I can't help but listen to it over and over again. Speaking of which, that song also plays during the show's final fight scene, which I thought was a fantastic choice because it helped make that whole sequence feel even more epic than it already was. The characters in the show are also very memorable. I already mentioned how I thought Jiwoo was a likable protagonist, but another character I enjoyed a whole lot was Choi Mujin. He's played by Asian American actor Rich Tin, who I haven't seen in anything else before, but in this show I thought he had such a great screen presence. You are drawn and pulled to this character the minute you first see him, and for me at least, he absolutely stole every single scene that he was in. Another noteworthy character is John Pildo, Jiwoo's partner in the police force, played by An Bohyun. Or is it An Bohyun? Like I said earlier in this video, I do not know how to pronounce Korean names for shit. Anyway, he has a similar motivation to Jiwoo, being this person who joined the police force in order to try and find someone who killed a family member of his. There is also a very subtle romance plot between these two characters, although admittedly I didn't find it very convincing until the last couple episodes. Throughout the series, I could tell that the show was trying to plant the seeds of a blossoming love story between the two, but I didn't really buy it at first. As I was watching, I had my doubts that the subplot would actually pay off in a convincing way, but fortunately, during the last two episodes, I feel like all of the elements of their romance fell into place rather nicely, and even though it's not the greatest romance subplot I've ever seen in a series, it was definitely serviceable enough for the story the show was trying to tell. Plus, I feel like the conclusion of that subplot helped enhance the themes of the show and enforce its tone very well. Overall, I feel like My Name was a very solid and wonderfully executed show. I felt very at home watching this, as it feels very similar to a lot of the other action films or shows that I really enjoy watching and have covered on this channel in the past. The show is only 8 episodes long, and the series wraps itself up pretty well with no loose strings attached. So if you really want a new show to binge over the course of a week, then I would highly recommend this one, especially if you really want to see more action films or shows with a badass female protagonist. Now, there's not much else I can really say about this show without getting into spoilers. So, if you haven't seen the show yet and want to avoid spoilers, then feel free to skip to the timestamp that is on the screen right now. As for the rest of you who have either already watched the show or just simply don't care enough about spoilers, then let's go. So when it comes to My Name, much like other mysteries and thrillers, things are not all as they seem to be. The show has twists and reveals that completely change the course of the narrative that are slowly, gradually revealed to the audience, one by one. First of all, remember how I mentioned at the start of this video how Choi Mujin gives Jiwoo the gun that killed her father? Jiwoo eventually finds out who the owner of the gun was, and it was none other than a police officer named Son Junsu, who, according to Jiwoo's boss, Giyu, died a long time ago. Jiwoo decides to try and find out who Son Junsu was, eventually coming to the realization that Son Junsu was none other than the real name of her father, Donhoon. Jiwoo confronts Choi Mujin with his information, who reveals to her that her father was an undercover cop working for Jiho, infiltrating the criminal organization. However, her father flipped sides. Mujin suspects that Jiho found out and that he must have been the one who killed him. Believing that Jiho was the man who killed her father, Jiwoo goes after him, only to find out that he didn't, providing her with evidence that Donhoon never flipped sides and was in fact always loyal to the police until the day he died. Naturally, this leads her to uncovering the identity of her father's true killer, none other than Choi Mujin himself. Upon discovering that Donhoon was an undercover cop this entire time, Mujin felt very betrayed and hurt, as he had always viewed Donhoon as a brother. Mujin killed Donhoon with his own gun, not only to get revenge for how he was betrayed, but to stop the police from taking down his criminal organization. Jiwoo renounces her allegiance to the organization upon learning of how she's been manipulated this entire time, swearing to kill Mujin. However, she's stopped by her partner and love interest, Bildo. He convinces her not to kill him, saying that her father sacrificed his life just to get Mujin into prison and that she should finish what he started, arresting Mujin the way her father wanted, so that he can stand trial. Jiwoo agrees to this, however, Mujin is angered upon finding out that Jiwoo will not be coming to him to get revenge. He doesn't want to go to prison. The only way he wants this whole situation to end is either she kills him or he kills her. So in order to motivate her to follow through with her revenge, Mujin kills Bildo in front of her. Not only is Mujin responsible for her father's death, but now he's responsible for the death of her lover. The two men most important to her have been stolen from her by Mujin. This causes Jiwoo to spiral. She loses her mind and decides that rather than taking the high road by arresting Mujin, she'd rather become a monster instead. This leads us to the final fight sequence of the whole series, and goddamn was it awesome. She single-handedly raids Mujin's headquarters, slaughtering and rampaging through all of his henchmen until she finally reaches him. And after a grueling, bloody one-on-one fight, she ultimately kills him. The series ends on a bittersweet note, where Jiwoo visits the graves of her parents and Bildo before being forced to carry on with the rest of her life completely alone in the world, her future now uncertain. First of all, as bittersweet and sad as the ending to the show was, I kind of appreciated it, because if Jiwoo really did take the high road, arresting Mujin and sending him to prison, then that obviously would have been very cliche. It's a lot more interesting for the story to end in the downfall of its main protagonist, and it's an ending that fits the dark and gritty vibe of the show's story rather well, considering the bleak and dark setting of the show. A happy ending would have felt out of place. I have to say though, I'm somewhat confused by Choi Mujin's motives throughout the storyline and how he manipulated Jiwoo. He killed her father and then for some reason decided to not only recruit her into his organization, but also help her uncover the truth and train her so that she could one day kill him. Sure, he needed someone to kill Jiho, but surely he could have gotten someone else to do that rather than making Jiwoo do it and risk the truth coming out. The only explanation I can think of for his actions throughout the story is that, well, it's obvious that a part of him feels remorseful for killing Donhoon. Sure, he felt betrayed by him and needed to ensure that the cops don't take down his organization, but that doesn't change the fact that Donhoon was still a very treasured friend and like a brother to him. He's conflicted by his duty to his organization and bond with Donhoon, and even though he knows that in the end Jiwoo would probably kill him, he decides to allow it anyway. Whatever happens, happens. Allowing himself to be killed by his best friend's daughter in order to make amends for what he was forced to do. Another topic I'd like to cover is that of Bildo. Like I mentioned in the spoiler-free section of this video, I didn't really buy the romance between him and Jiwoo at first until, like, the last couple of episodes. I'm not entirely sure why, but it was around the second-to-last episode that the romance started to click into place for me. Plus, it helps knowing that the romance was in the show in order to set up the ending to the show. Pildo dying helped enhance the show's ending, and it forced the bleak and bittersweet tone of the world his characters inhabit. Without the build-up of the romance and its tragic culmination, then we wouldn't have gotten the impactful, emotionally driven ending and final battle that we got. Another reason why the romance is so bittersweet is because Jiwoo is a character who lives a very joyless life. There's even a scene in this show where Pildo asks her if she has any friends or if she does anything fun or has any hobbies, to which she replies, "Is life supposed to be fun?" Which is such a simple line, but it goes a long way to show you what her inner world must feel like. But regardless of how dark, bleak, and joyless her life is, Pildo becomes a spark of light for her. She's finally found someone who understands her, someone who knows how to comfort her, treat her right for once in her life. She gets to know what it's like to be loved by someone. But Mugen takes that from her. She loses the one person in the world who understands her, and thus her life reverts back to its original bleak, dark, and joyless state. Even though I wasn't sold on the romance at first, and thought it wasn't one of the best ones I've ever seen, I still appreciate its conclusion based on those merits alone. It was a necessary inclusion so that the writer could tell the story they wanted to tell. Anyway, so that's all I wanted to discuss when it comes to the spoiler section of this video, so let's move on to my final thoughts. Overall, I really enjoyed my time with the show. It was one of those shows that I knew absolutely nothing about going in. I just randomly found it on Netflix one day, saw that it had good ratings, and decided to give it a try, go into it blind. I ended up becoming pleasantly surprised by this show because it was way more engaging and gripping than I expected, with fantastic acting, fight choreography, filmmaking, and more. If you're into crime dramas, revenge thrillers, mysteries, and great action, then I definitely would recommend My Name if you haven't already watched it. Like I said, it's only 8 episodes, so it can be easily binged within a week if you're bored and need something new to sink your teeth into, especially if you like some of the movies I compared it to at the beginning of this video, or if you like shows and movies similar to what I described. My Name is a very solid show, with great filmmaking and a memorable story, so if you haven't already watched it and it sounds like something you might enjoy, then definitely give it a chance. But if you've already seen the show and have randomly stumbled across this video somehow, then what are your thoughts on it? Feel free to let me know down in the comments below, and with that being said, thank you so much for checking out this video, and I hope to see you in the next one.